Hello, welcome back to another video of Brandon Lee Collectibles on my own personal Brandon Lee page. In this video, I was able to find a lot more photos that I've got. They're probably already ones that are already on the photos album. But I was just sort of rummaging through bits and pieces I've got, and I feel like I want to go over them and talk about them in more detail. But starting off with this one here. This is a photograph of Brandon Lee and David Darlow from Kung Fu, The Next Generation. And on the back, with a piece of paper that's actually been stuck to the photograph, which is original typed information about this. And it says on the back here, it's got Brandon Lee left, David Darlow, star as son and father, who used their command of the martial arts to serve righteous people in dire aid in Kung Fu, The Next Generation, to be broadcast on the CBS Summer Playhouse, Friday, June 19th, 8 to 9pm ET on CBS Television Network. So that's really interesting information to have, and this is Friday, June 19th. So this is like really early on. He's quite a young guy here, so he's just starting out in television, and then of course it progressed gradually into film. But that's a nice bit of information there. And then this one here is with them both again. That's with David Darlow. Sat with Brandon Lee, but it looks like they're in a field somewhere, or out in the countryside there. And Brandon Lee's got his hands on his head, and he's looking really sort of either shocked or very excited there. But connected with that is this here. This is all written by Brandon Lee. This is actually only a copy, so this is not an original. But he's put on here to David, the actor that's in the photograph with him, we're going to be on TV, what will happen next, Brandon? And he's put, PS, I don't know, Gordon R. Dickinson was on Oriental Philosopher, so he's just referring to another actor there on another TV program. But he's obviously very excited that he's going to be on TV with David Darlow, who is his co-star in Kung Fu, The Next Generation, which was 1987. And then moving on from that, I have got these stills here, which were from Kung Fu the movie with David Carradine. So he's got his hair cut really short there, like a Buddhist monk. So this would have been one of his first sort of co-starring roles in television movie with David Carradine. So really, really nice shots of Brandon in his younger days, in his earlier career, just starting out. This one here is from Rapid Fire. I don't think I've ever seen that in the film, but he's inside the house there, and it looks like he's holding onto a police officer there. He's got him in a headlock there, but I'm pretty sure it's not in the film. Or it could either be a deleted scene or just edited out, but it's quite interesting to see that, to have that, as maybe it could even be a film scene that we don't know about, but it's certainly not in the film itself. And then these ones here were from his only Hong Kong production, from Legacy of Rage, which was his very first film that he made, and his only film that he made in Hong Kong. So he was only a young guy here in this first film. That's a very cocky photograph, that one of him there. It looks very much like his father now, I think. and that's a pretty well-known one. And then that one looks like it's more on the set, maybe in between shots, on the set of Legacy of Rage. So he's just relaxing in that shot, so that's another rare shot of him. And then this one here is one of my favourites here, and this is it, just him at ease, where he's slightly older here, and I don't know the background behind the photo, but I'm guessing he's in an interview, or he's just having a casual talk with somebody there. But you could see just by that he's just him, you know, that's his personality, and that's who he was. Great guy. This one here is from Rapid Fire. This has actually been signed just up here by Ali Elong, I think that's pronounced. I'm not sure if I've said that right, but that's this guy here. He's the guy that Brandon Lee fights at the end, or towards the end of Rapid Fire. And he's very well known for like films, like action films of like mid 80s, early 90s. But it's another nice example there. And then this one here is a mini poster for The Crow. But this is a mini poster at the time when it came out to promote the motion picture soundtrack. And down the bottom in the red, you've got all the information there of the different tracks that were on the album that came out. So it's really nice when they made The Crow that they also made a full album. And also the music that you can probably hear now is actually the score from The Crow, which is from this CD. So really, really nice music. And then moving on over here, I've got these two here, which I quite find interesting, which are these are actually two postcards. That's with Dolph Lundgren from Showdown or Tokyo. And there are two different shots there, one with Brandon in his shirt and tie, and the other one with his t-shirt, which is the one that they put on the main poster for the film. It's nice to see the comparison that they actually tried a different shot with him in shirt and tie. That's another nice shot, that one there, Brandon Lee. And then that there, that's I think that's Japanese, that one. That's like advertising the 1986 Legacy of Rage. I think that's come out of that might be a mini poster, or that's come out of a magazine, the original of the Times. So it's kept in its plastic covering to keep it protected as its original and from that time period. That's another photo there from that's Kung Fu the movie, where he's got his head shaved there. So he's looking a bit different there from Kung Fu the movie. And so that's 1986, and then he did Kung Fu the Next Generation, which was 1987. And then I've got these ones, which are the original press stills from Rapid Fire. You can see that's the director there from Rapid Fire, and again down there he's standing there with Brandon Lee on the motorcycle. And Brandon Lee and Kate Hodge from Rapid Fire. There's that one there. Rapid Fire again, they're very well known shots, Brandon Lee. Same again there, co-stars. So this is actually the whole set from Rapid Fire. This one here, this is a card, like a card material, this one, which is again very rare again, which I purchased just quite a few years ago, probably not long after he died, and I just really love that photo of him. He just comes across as really sort of very impish, almost very sort of cheeky look there. But on the back you've got all his details on the back there, and his life and his career, and just when he was born, and of course sadly when he died. It's good to have all the extra information, and you've also got his height on there, which it does say on here he was over 6 foot, which doesn't surprise me. You can see quite clearly he was a lot bigger, or would have been a lot taller than his father was. And then just here I have got, here's another original photograph that is Alex Poyas from the on the set of The Crow. That's original press still from The Crow. And then these ones here are Mexican lobby cards. That is from Laser Mission, which was 1989, which was the second film that he made. That's probably the only lobby card I've actually got on him. And then these three again are from Legacy of Rage, which are Mexican. I always get a bit confused with Legacy of Rage, because as the original poster shows, or on these lobby cards or front of house stills, shows the image in the background of his father, Bruce Lee. Now, I don't know why that was put in the film, not in the film, sorry, but on the poster or the lobby card image, but I'm guessing it was to maybe to boost the picture more, to make it try and make it more popular as with the Lee name, and put his father in the background with an image of Brandon Lee in front to try and boost the production. That's all I'm thinking, but I might be completely wrong. But yeah, so they're nice four lobby cards there. And yeah, I think that's it for this video. So I hope to show more in the next one, and that's it. So hope you enjoyed this one. Thanks very much. Bye.